Good morning. Graduating students will be seated in the first 12 rows. Please take your seats behind the first 12 rows. Please take your seats behind the first 12 rows. And please pay attention to social distancing. Thank you. Good morning. Graduating students will be seated in the first 12 rows. Please take your seats behind the first 12 rows. Please take your seats behind the first 12 rows. And please pay attention to social distancing. Thank you. Good morning and welcome to Art Center College of Design's Fall 2021 graduation ceremony. Please promptly take your seats behind the first 12 rows. And as a courtesy to others, please turn off your cell phones. We would also like to remind you for your own safety and those around you, please keep your face mask on at all times while inside the building. We will begin the ceremony momentarily. Thank you. Good morning and welcome to Art Center College of Design's Fall 2021 graduation ceremony. Please promptly take your seats behind the first 12 rows. And as a courtesy to others, please turn off your cell phones. We would also like to remind you, for your safety and those around you, please keep your face mask on at all times while inside the building. We will begin the ceremony momentarily. Thank you. Good morning. Please take your seats behind the first 12 rows. Please take your seats behind the first 12 rows. The students will be seated in the first 12 rows. Thank you. Good morning and welcome to Art Center College of Design's Fall 2021 graduation ceremony. Please promptly take your seats. The ceremony is about to begin. Please promptly take your seats. As a courtesy to others, please turn off your cell phones. The ceremony is about to begin. Thank you. Thank you.
this one?
Yes. Wait, good morning.
I'm sorry. Gwen, do you want me to say this? Please welcome.
Yes. Good morning. Yes.
Good morning. We will now begin the graduation ceremony. Please welcome the leadership and special guests of Art Center College of Design. Art Center is proud to introduce the fall 2021 graduating class. Welcome the president of Art Center College of Design, Dr. Lorne Buckman.
Thank you and good morning. In the spirit of resilience of this beautiful community, and recognizing the great joy of physically assembling in celebration for the first time in 2 years, I welcome you to the fall 2021 in-person Art Center College of Design graduation ceremonies. We have traveled a long and difficult road to get here, obviously still not completely done with the pandemic, but far enough along the way for us to gather again. And the remarkable students graduating today, some in person, some still remote, have all had to endure the many challenges of COVID and the difficult, unexpected turn in their educational experience. The power of their story, however, has not so much to do with what happened to them, but with how they responded. With uncommon strength and tenacity, they persisted in their learning. With courage essential to a vibrant creative life, they found a way to forge a path in the unknown. In strenuous conditions, they triumphed. Can we imagine a graduating class more distinguished? I acknowledge them not only for their completion of a rigorous Art Center education, but for the spirit of human flourishing they represent. But don't just take it from me. With the intention of creating an end-of-year holiday video, our innovative marketing and communications folks actually went out and asked a group of students about their experience these last 2 years, a cross-section of students, not just those graduating. When I saw an early cut, I was so struck by its content, I knew I had to show it to all of you today. The story these students tell is inspiring. There's a beautiful arc to their narrative. It moves from a dispirited beginning to new phases of discovery, to new experiences, new ways of working, of making. You will see how impediment yields to opportunity, how problems bend to solution, and how isolation gives way to a longing for community and place. Have a look.
Oh man, that was really, really hard for me.
March was intense.
It sucked.
And you can like see that I was like, oh, April would be here, but it never was.
It was pretty discouraging in the beginning.
I studied a lot. I was lucky enough to have other things to think about, and that was my way to avoid getting super bummed out.
That was challenging at first. When I look back at it, that kind of gave me strength.
It was actually the pandemic that kind of forced me to change a lot.
In the pandemic, I've actually branched out a lot more.
I was able to jump out of the box.
Like, I've done murals for a class.
Performance and installation.
I was in Austin, Texas.
I just finished up an internship at Apple.
I got back into the theater. My first big commission.
A lot of people just started reaching out to a lot of people and really trying to build those connections.
One of the students, he's taken the step to make like this giant Discord for all the majors, and a lot of people have been able to ask for help and interact in it.
I really want to see more interdisciplinary engagement.
More opportunity for connecting across like departments.
I would love to see Art Center just bring all the majors together in more ways.
I'm really just excited for like everyone to just be on campus again.
Well, first, I'm so glad to meet all the people that I met on Zoom.
Just getting back into that sense of community and that creative environment.
Having everybody in the same place again. I almost forgot what it was like.
Man, like, I was really attached to this place.
This is where I should be at.
I've stayed here till 2 a.m. crying, laughing. Like, this is the place where it all happens, you know?
Well, there it is. Couldn't have been said better. No better way to tell that story. So, this pandemic does suck, as it was so eloquently stated. But student resilience speaks volumes about the quality human beings that attend Art Center, and particularly about the ones we are recognizing today. And one final point to make in all of this. The more I explore creativity and the more I have opportunity to talk with artists and designers, the more I learn about the rich place of discovery we call uncertainty. And the conditions of these past 2 years have been nothing if not uncertain. Experiencing the unknown territory of the pandemic mirrors what is almost an everyday experience for creatives, routinely entering unfamiliar worlds to engage, to innovate, to find what only making reveals. As such, graduating class of fall 21, you know something vital about the untrodden path. You understand that uncertainty is a necessary condition of invention. And that is as true for the studio experience as it is for how we live. Harvest these lessons, this hard-earned wisdom. In the end, we embark on a journey through the unknown and discover as we create within it. But we need the courage, the skill, the education to deal with uncertainty in the first place. You have all of that now. It's yours. I hold deep excitement for what lies ahead for you graduates. Congratulations to each and every one of you, and thank you. So I'd now like to introduce the educational leadership of Art Center, as well as some special guests who are with us today. Please stand when I call your name. In the audience, Art Center trustee Wes Coleman and Bruce Haven. And they are joined by fellow trustees watching via our live stream, Ron Bensian, Chris Birchby, Sue Matthews-Hale, Tim Kobe, Melissa Laura, Sam Mann, and Elise Williams. Also in the audience, Alejandro Sandoval, Vice President of Student Government. And now this beautifully masked crew here. On stage, today's commencement speaker, Professor Errol Gerson. Karen Hoffman, our Provost. Ray Karolico, Associate Provost of Student Affairs and Dean of Students. Sean Adams, Chair, Graduate and Undergraduate Graphic Design. Guillaume Aretos, Chair, Entertainment Design. Laura Cooper, Chair, Fine Art. Ann Cutting, Interim Chair, Photography and Imaging. Stan Douglas, Chair, Graduate Art. Chris Hacker, Chair, Product Design. Maggie Hendry, Chair, Interaction Design and Graduate Media Design Practices. Ross Lamana, Chair, Graduate in an Undergraduate Film. David Makarski, Chair, Graduate and Undergraduate Environmental Design. Andy Ogden, Chair, Graduate Industrial Design. Jay Sanders, Executive Director, Transportation Design. And Aaron Smith, Associate Chair, Illustration. Please join me in a warm round of applause in acknowledgement of their influence and leadership. I would also like to recognize another vital group of individuals, some in attendance, others watching today, whose daily contributions are at the heart of the educational process. Without the fine faculty of Art Center, the caliber of work produced by our students would not be possible, and we owe them our gratitude for their dedicated efforts in the classroom. At the same time, Art Center administrators, admissions counselors, student service providers, content creators, fundraisers, and more all work tirelessly behind the scenes to directly and indirectly support our incredible students. We thank them for what they do and for all that they make possible. Thank you. And now I'd like to recognize those of you attending today, both here in the auditorium and watching from afar. While we have nearly 200 students graduating today, more than 50 of them are participating in today's ceremony virtually. Several of our graduates represent more than a dozen international countries with families and friends joining us from around the world, including Australia, Canada, China, France, Hong Kong, India, Indonesia, Japan, Korea, Mexico, Philippines, Spain, United Kingdom, and Zimbabwe. Similarly, our domestic students represent nearly a dozen U.S. states, and we welcome those of you who are with us in person or watching nationwide. It's important to recognize that all of our graduates are part of a larger whole, with fathers and mothers, grandparents, spouses, lovers, partners, aunts and uncles, sisters, brothers and friends of all kinds who have supported our graduates in their journey. We have a tradition here at Arts Center. I'd like to ask all the graduates to rise, to look back at friends and family, and to thank them for what they have done to make this day possible. Thank you all. See, that was fun. Yeah. Now, as we continue, I would like to give you a quick overview of this morning's program. We will begin with the presentation of our Student Leadership Award, remarks by our valedictorian, and then followed by our commencement speaker. And then we will move to the conferral of degrees to our graduating students. So let's get started. Please welcome our Dean of Students, Ray Karolico, who will present the Student Leadership Award.
Thank you, Lauren. Hello, everyone. Every semester, the Center for the Student Experience organizes a committee that represents the diverse perspectives of our creative community of faculty, staff, and students to recognize one individual in the graduating class who exemplifies a particular kind of leadership, defined as a person who contributes creatively to the world while prioritizing human relationships. After such a long period of our entire campus working remotely and virtually, it seems particularly fitting that this semester, as we celebrate our graduating class together in this hybrid format again, this semester's committee chose to honor an individual who explained that her decision to pursue an undergraduate degree at Arts Center after already earning a master's degree in mechanical engineering was driven by her desire to enrich herself and also to connect other people and the rest of the world through the power of design. This individual's leadership experience as a kind of human bridge connecting individuals and communities includes work experiences as an orientation leader, as a teaching assistant, as a department peer coach, co-leading a student club, participating in an exchange program in the Netherlands, and collaborations in Los Angeles County to advance the health and well-being experiences of local residents. Her work has already earned multiple international honors and prizes, but more significantly, her nominators recognized her commitment to hard work, playful ideas, research and teamwork, values for sustainability and inclusion, and an inspiring attitude of joy combined with responsibility. Celebrating all the starts and stops that life can present as challenges that need those bridges of leadership to offer safe passage, it is my honor to present the Fall 2021 Student Leadership Award to this individual, graduating today with a Bachelor of Science degree in Product Design and a minor in Social Innovation, Yankee Lee.
Good morning. Thank you, Ray, for your kind introduction. And hello, grads of Fall 21. Congratulations, we made it. First of all, I would like to personally thank Lee Hoffman for my nomination and the committee for the honor of receiving the Student Leadership Award. I am very flattered. Before Arts Center, I actually went to two universities, so I was used to sitting in like huge classrooms, listening to formal lectures and not making much connection between myself and the professors and classmates. But at our center, however, it's our collaborative work in small studios with personal yet professional critiques and feedback. I gained teammates, friends, and mentors. At our center, everyone has such a unique personality, but one common thread is that the passion we share and the sincerity we have learned to applaud others for their hard works, their ideas, and their courage to take on new challenges. I remember once being invited to my teacher's personal studio to just get further guidance of how to move forward for my design pieces. And at that afternoon, we talked about movies, music, our dogs, our lives. And at the meantime, I got the work done. I also remember pulling an all-nighter on Hillside campus with a friend. We actually wrapped up with ourselves all pieces of fabric that we can find in our trunks because we're complaining about the freezing cold air conditioning, the never finished homework, and also dreaming about our future. Actually, as an introvert, I was afraid of making comments or talking about my dreams in the future. That is not how I was raised in the past. But it is you, my classmates, my friends, and my mentors and teachers. You helped me to assert my point of view and also gave me the courage to share my dreams and passions. For that, I am truly, truly grateful. This July, very luckily and gratefully, I became a mom. with a newborn baby to take care of and almost 2 years of online classes, I feel really disconnected from the Art Center community. But just a couple weeks ago, while seeing the alumni wall at 1111 building, where each one of us is represented by an orange circle, and we connected into a map, I just regained this deeper sense of belonging again. I understand that no circle is perfect, neither is our center. But with all the struggles, confusions, laughter, and tears, oxygen, our center is like oxygen for me already. So I am so proud to be one of the orange circles that is connected with each one of you. We are passionate, adventurous, and confident. And together, we can make a difference. And last and finally, I want to say thank you to my husband. Without you, there's no way that I can do it by myself. And again, congratulations for us all. Thank you.
Thank you for those beautiful words and that wonderful, heartfelt talk. Just a little bit of news for you all. We used the pandemic as a time to re-roof the Hillside campus and to put in a whole new HVAC system. So I don't know what it's going to be like to be, you know, experience Art Center as a student without the roof leaking, without it being freezing and the whole rest of it, but we'll forge on. All right, it's now my pleasure to invite our provost, Karen Hoffman, to introduce our valedictorian. Karen.
Thank you, Lauren. What a pleasure being here today. Before I get started, I just want to extend my congratulations to all of you and everyone online We are incredibly proud of your accomplishments, your resilience. The creativity is just unmatched. And we cannot wait to see what you do in the future. So congrats to all of you. As many of you know, it is customary for us to ask a member of the graduating class who has the highest academic achievement to offer a few words of reflection and celebration. It is my pleasure to announce Alice Yang as our valedictorian this term. Prior to attending Art Center, Alice graduated from UC Irvine with two Bachelor of Arts degrees, one in psychology and social behavior, and the other in art. During her time studying entertainment arts in our illustration department, she served as a teacher's assistant for several classes, and she worked freelance as a colorist for Disney Publishing Worldwide, and as a background painter for Passion Pictures. Alice is graduating today having maintained an astounding cumulative GPA of 3.97. Congratulations, Alice. Please join us on stage.
Hi, my name is Alice, and I'm the one responsible for throwing some cliches at you today. When I first shared the news with my parents that I'd been selected as valedictorian, they replied, "Oh, what's that?" At which point, I realized I also did not know. A few online searches later, we were all very happy, but it did get me thinking about their question philosophically. What is that? And what does it mean to be an Art Center graduate? After much reflection, I have concluded that it means to be really good at failing. I remember stepping into the 1111 building on my first day, feeling invincible, excited to show what I was capable of. And then I went to my first figure drawing class. After the first few time poses, I looked to my left and then to my right, and I realized I was the worst one there. Through my time at Art Center, this feeling has stayed with me, and I only began to reconcile this feeling recently when I remembered that we all began making art because we had something inside that we wanted to share with the world. In the end, it's not about being better than the person next to us, but rather being comfortable with trying and failing our way forward over and over again until our art says what we want it to. As we sit here today, great accomplishments in hand, you and I know it wasn't all glamorous. All those nights of begging the software gods for a file recovery, restarting a project the night before because we misread the instructions, and then getting ripped apart during critique anyway. Staying up too late, and then promising ourselves we'll never stay up that late again, and then somehow doing it all over again. Beyond any of the skills we've learned, Art Center has provided us with a safe space to fail and learn to try again and again and again. One of my professors once told us that when we leave, we should have the confidence to pursue any creative idea we have. Coming here was arguably the craziest idea we could have had, so there's really nothing left to be scared of anymore. Congratulations, class of 2021. I look forward to seeing all the other brave, creative ideas you'll follow. Lastly, before I go, I'd like to thank the illustration department and our chair, Anne Field. I'd also like to recognize our incredible faculty for creating a safe space for us to be ourselves and to fail fearlessly. Lastly, thank you to all our loved ones in the audience or at home, and a special shout out to my parents and my best friend in the audience today. Many of us would not be here without you, your love, and your support, so thank you.
Thank you so much, and congratulations, Alice. At our graduation ceremonies this past summer, I had occasion to cite a deeply valued member of this community for his 50 years of teaching. That's 5-0. Provost Hoffman followed up with a tribute at one of our community events. That individual is the beloved Bob Sherman, attending today in celebration of his grandson, Milo, who is graduating in illustration with distinction. It's deeply, deeply moving to me to witness the continued brilliance of this family at Art Center, and I stand here offering my love and respect to them all. And now I have the distinct honor to recognize another wonderful colleague and friend, the Venerable Errol Gerson, who will deliver the commencement address today. He too has reached this milestone, 50 years of distinguished teaching at Art Center College of Design. Indeed, for 5 decades, Professor Gerson has given generously to the students of this college. For a remarkable span of time, he has opened minds and hearts in ways unimaginable. For 50 years, this man has offered his students the kind of thinking and wisdom that comes only from the greatest of our teachers. Born and raised in South Africa, Professor Gerson came to California in 1966 to study accounting at USC, and then went on to programs of finance and management at the MBA level. And so, in the spirit of the great accountant that he is, Professor Gerson tells us that in his 50 years, he has mentored a total of 5,350 students. But who's counting, right? Right. And knowing him, I'm sure he recalls every name, where they are now, their special gifts, and the final grade he assigned to them for the course. He's a management consultant, an entrepreneur, a coach, a first-rate mind in financial strategy and business development. He is a writer and a philosopher. He is many, many things. But for today, I want to acknowledge his teaching. Recently, a friend asked me about Professor Gerson and what makes him special. And I found myself answering quite spontaneously with the following sentiment. He's a born teacher. He loves sharing what he knows. He inspires students to discover what matters to them. He teaches those fortunate enough to study with him the critical business principles they need for their professional lives, but really, he teaches them about life. And this most of all, he distinguishes himself with a deep love for and belief in his students. Anyone who has ever had the opportunity to talk with Professor Gerson about his teaching will always hear him go on and on about this student's great achievement or that student's amazing business triumph. He wears his love of students like a sash around his chest. And if I've learned anything from the faculty at Art Center, great teaching is always a product of great love. And Mr. Gerson is a prime example of that beautiful alchemy. Before I hand over the podium to our illustrious professor, I want him to know that I recommended to the Board of Trustees at their recent October meeting a resolution of gratitude for his amazing work. The board adopted it unanimously. And this is a surprise to him, but I wanted to read to all of you the citation in honor, the citation of honor from the board, and here it is. And it reads as follows: with abundant pride and heartfelt appreciation, the Art Center College of Design Board of Trustees wishes to recognize Errol Gerson for his years of dedicated service to the college. Whereas Errol's expertise is in accounting, finance, and management, and whereas he brought his expertise to Art Center joining the faculty in 1971, and whereas he has been teaching entrepreneurship, leadership, and business management courses for more than 50 years, and whereas during that time he has educated and mentored thousands of students. Now therefore, be it resolved, the Board of Trustees offers its profound gratitude to Errol Gerson for his numerous contributions to furthering the mission of Art Center, supporting its students, and expanding its global community of artists and designers. Congratulations, Errol. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Errol Gerson.
Thank you, Lauren. Board of Trustees, members of the executive staff, department chairman, faculty, parents, but especially you, the graduating class of fall 2021. Congratulations. Before I begin, just a little bit of business. If you have a cell phone, would you do me a favor and turn it on? I would hate for you to miss a text, a tweet, or an email, so make sure it's on. By the way, after you receive your diploma, keep moving in case they try to take it back from you. My friends, today I will share with you my love of philosophy by telling you two simple stories, one that impacted my life in ways that have been with me since I graduated, and one that happened at Art Center. I graduated in 1971 into one of the deepest recessions in the United States. The interest rate in the economy was 16%. And the chances of getting a job with an undergraduate degree in accounting were very small. But I went home, and on my Royal typewriter, because remember, I graduated without a computer, without the internet, and without a word processor. So I typed on my Royal typewriter in the ugliest type font known to man, Times New Roman. And I then took it to a center, and they made copies on some cheap, horrible paper. And I sent out 30 of them, and I waited a week, and I waited 2 weeks, and I waited 3 weeks, and nothing came. So I sent out 30 more, and 3 weeks later, nothing had come. I went home, and I started pounding the wall. My next-door neighbor was an architect, asked me, "What the hell is the matter with you?" And I told her. She said, "Let me see your resume." She looked at my resume and she went, "That's disgusting." She said, "Come with me." She put me in her car and she drove me, and you will know this, to Kelly Paper Company. Oh my God, I now saw the most beautiful papers I had ever seen in my life. And I chose Strathmore, and with a little bit of money I had, I could afford 6 pieces of paper, which the gentleman said he would cut 8.5 by 11. And I said, "No, sir. I want you to cut it 8.5 by 11 1/8. He said, "But there's no such paper." I said, "There is now." He looked at me, and I walked out, and I went to a little printing company in those days that had a Heidelberg press. And I asked the gentleman, "Besides Times New Roman, are there any other typefaces?" He handed me this book of type, and I fell in love with Helvetica. He sent my resume out for typesetting, yes, typesetting, not on the computer, to the Pacific Type House in Venice, California. And he called me 2 weeks later and said, "The plate had arrived, come over, we're gonna print a resume." He printed my resume and he said, "Now I'm gonna cut your paper because it's not the right size." I said, "No, sir, please don't cut the paper. On the 1/8 of an inch, can you put the Art Center crimson color?" He said, "But of course." But he said, "You know, when I do, you'll never be able to fold this in a number 10 envelope." I said, "That's okay. I've had 10 by 12 envelopes made specifically." So he did. And I sent out 4 resumes. 2 days later, my phone rang. The gentleman said, "I'm so-and-so from IBM. Do you know why I've called you?" I said, "Yes, sir, I do." He said, "Tell me." I said, "Well, they gave you a bunch of resumes, 50 of them, and you tapped them on the desk, and one of them stuck out an eighth of an inch, and it was mine." Ladies and gentlemen, they flew me to New York, and then Arthur Andersen, the great accounting company, told me the same story. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to succeed in life, stick out an eighth of an inch. Lesson number two, 25 years ago. Students sat in my class, wouldn't answer my questions, wouldn't talk to me, wouldn't look at me. And it was week 9, and I gave my famous lecture about the gratitude attitude. And he came to me after class, and he said, "I don't believe any of this crap you're talking about." "What crap are you talking about?" He said, "All this gratitude nonsense. It's all religious BS. I said, "It is?" He said, "Yeah, I know what you are." I said, "You do? What am I?" He said, "You're a born-again Christian. You're trying to make us all Christians." I said, "You know, my rabbi would be very surprised to hear that." I said, "Are you grateful to your parents for raising you?" He said, "I'm an accident of an egg and a sperm." I said, "You grateful to your teachers in high school?" He said, "No, they got paid by property taxes." I said, "Are you grateful to me for teaching you at Art Center?" He said, "Excuse me, I pay tuition and I pay your salary. You have to teach me." And I said, "No, I don't have to, I choose to." "So what are you grateful for?" He said, "Nothing." I said, "Excuse me, do you have a good bed in your house?" He said, "What's a good bed?" I said, "Okay, do you have a bad bed?" He said, "What's a bad bed?" I said, "Well, it's bowed. And you'd wake up with a pain in your back and you tell all the students you have a bad bed." He said, "Okay, I have a good bed." I said, "Good. Tomorrow morning, I want you to turn to your bed and say, 'Thank you for giving me a good night's rest.'" He flipped me off and walked out. He came back a week later, walked up to me and said, "I gotta talk to you at the end of class." End of class, he comes to me and he says, "You've no idea the trouble you got me in." I said, "Excuse me?" He said, "You were in my head, so I woke up the next morning and I'm not gonna say that. And I woke up every morning and I would not say, 'Thank you for giving me a good night's rest.' But on Saturday morning, it was a beautiful day. And my girlfriend was in the shower. I made breakfast and I picked some flowers. I said, 'Wow, how romantic.' And then I made my bed and you jumped in my head. And I thought, 'What the hell?' And I said, 'Thank you for giving me a good night's rest.' And as I said it, my girlfriend stepped out of the shower. And she said, 'Honey, who are you talking to?' I said, 'Nobody.' She said, 'Excuse me, I'm not stupid and I'm not deaf. Who are you talking to?' And I told her the story. And she looked at me and she said, "I wish I was important as your bed, that you would express gratitude towards me because I've been with you for 5 years. I said, "How was that?" He said, she burst into tears. I said, "How was that?" He said, "Made me feel bad." I said, "What do you do about it?" He said, "Errol, we sat down and had a 6-hour conversation. And it was the first time in my life that I truly felt gratitude." The very emotional story for me. I have good news. He went on to graduate with distinction. He taught at Art Center for 12 years. He married her. They have 3 children. And he writes to me every 6 months. And he thanks me for helping him understand the power of gratitude. And he says, "I'm not religious yet, but I'm an agnostic, so I guess there's hope for me. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to be successful, you better have a gratitude attitude. So now we come to the best part of my speech. It's the end. I'm going to wish you two things that you're going to find very strange. I'm going to wish you challenge, and I'm going to wish you adversity. And I'll tell you why. Because I know, armed with an Art Center education, with an Art Center work ethic, and with the passion and desire and the discipline that you have, I know without any doubt that you will overcome the challenge and adversity. All you have to do is continue to have desire, continue to have determination, and continue to have a good attitude. You know, my friends, it's your attitude, not your aptitude, that will determine your altitude. You know, my friends, God gave you two ends, one to think with and one to sit on. Your success depends on which one you use more. Congratulations to the graduating class of fall 2021. I believe in you. I am proud of you. And as Art Center has said, go make change. I am from the country of South Africa where I was born. And there's a proverb that I'd like to share with you. And I hope you remember this because it's been with me most of my life. If you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go far, go with other people. Congratulations and thank you.
Thank you, Earl. Thank you so much for everything and for all that you've brought to this community. We are filled with gratitude for you. And now, a moment we've all been waiting for, the conferral of degrees. Let's begin.
As we begin, the degrees will be conferred in alphabetical order by major, beginning with the graduate programs, followed by the undergraduate programs. When students' names are announced, their work will be shown on the screen. And now, the conferral of degrees begins with graduate art.
Good morning, and congratulations to all of you. My name is Stan Douglas. I'm the chair of graduate art. And I'm delighted this morning to present to you our candidates for an MFA in art. Thank you.
Participating from home, Haijing Chen. From Agnes Martin to Suzuki Zen in the Western context. David Daigle. Objects in photographs as objective signifiers. Charles Engelman, How They Lie, Monuments in a Time of Crisis. Laura LaRaz, Bad, Bad Painting. Now graduate film.
Hi, I'm Ross LaManna, Chair of Undergraduate and Graduate Film. It's great to be here. I see half of many familiar faces, and I'm very proud to present our candidates for Master of Fine Art Master of Film. It is also fine art, damn it.
Samantha Trixie Eisen, Roger Deakins, the Master Cinematography. Matthew Colston, Netflix, The Wave of the Future, an analysis of the digital film distribution model. Ming-Ji Tang, study on director Krzysztof Kozlowski's tone and style in filmmaking based on Three Colors. And participating from home, Liberty Joy Ingram Gonzalez.
Thank you.
Christopher Pie. Wei Zhang. Now, graduate industrial design.
Good morning, my name is Andy Ogden. I'm the chair of Graduate Industrial Design. It's my pleasure to introduce a group of designers that have demonstrated the ability to create value for others while also working with our faculty to reinvent the ways we can work and learn together. Please join me with congratulations as we introduce our candidates for a Master of Science in Industrial Design.
Eddie Lee Winko, Sanajet, and automatic automobile sanitation solution for businesses at a cost-effective rate. Shin Shi, Photone, a window treatment that delights your life. Hawei Yuan, Vanguard, a one-stop station for virtual possessions management, providing an affordable legal service to protect your digital assets. And participating from home, Long Jackie Shen, Cookmaster, a smart, easy-to-use learning system to help new cooks. Yunfei Li, Yo-Yo, a digital AI travel agency to help the inexperienced group traveler create an optimal plan for their budget and needs. Now, graduate media design practices.
Good morning, I'm Maggie Hendry, Chair of Media Design Practices here at Art Center. Welcome. It's a real honor and with a great deal of pride on the part of myself and all of the faculty that we present to your candidate for a Master's of Fine Art in Media Design Practices.
Participating from home, Amor Bizarro, Mind with Matter. And now, Graduate Transportation Systems and Design.
Hi, my name is Jay Sanders. I'm Executive Director in the Transportation Design Department. Stuart Reed, who's Chair of the Department, and Jeff Wardle, who's Executive Director of the Graduate Program, are unable to be here today, but I know that they, along with the faculty, are incredibly proud of the students we're presenting today. So on behalf of Stuart and Jeff, we'd like to announce the candidates for Master of Science in Graduate Transportation Systems and Design.
Karen Liu, Urban Co-Creation, Transportation Planning Participatory Approaches. James Zhu, what role do interpersonal activities play in the creation of a satisfying social mobility experience for the autonomous mobility era? And participating from home, Ru Xinbai, personalized trust-building experience with autonomous vehicle. We will now begin the undergraduate degree presentation with advertising.
Hello, I'm Sean Adams. I'm chair of undergraduate and graduate graphic design, and I'm here to represent Gary Goldsmith, chair, and Tom Cordner, professor, who have asked me to express their highest praise for this group of candidates for a Bachelor of Fine Arts in advertising.
Fernand Juan Schoeffer, with a minor in creative writing. Austin Groveman. Anya Ningham. And participating from home, Gabrielle Balzen, with honors. Now, entertainment design.
Hello, everyone. My name is Guillaume Moretos. I'm the chair of entertainment design. I'm very proud of these young people who are coming right here. And also the ones who are not here. It is my honor to introduce to you the candidates for Bachelor of Science in Entertainment Design.
E. Xavier Lam. Shaylee Jessica Garcia Shu, with honors. Zhufang Shu. Ella Louise Kahn, with distinction and a minor in creative writing. Zhuiying Lin, with honors. Eunhei Park, with honors. Huining Shi, with honors. Masai Suga. Matthew Wong, with honors. Janelle Joanne Yuan, with honors. And participating from home, Jacob Gonzalez, with honors. Nicholas Wong, with honors. Jin Zhang, with honors. Ziwan Li. Shuchan Shi, with honors. Andrew Wong, with distinction. Boya Xia. Jun Ji Yin. Next, environmental design.
Good morning. I'm David Makarski, the chair of graduate and undergraduate environmental design. And it's my great pleasure to introduce our candidates for a Bachelor of Science in Environmental Design. This is one great group of spatial experience designers.
Yian An, with distinction. Wei-Zi Song, with distinction, and a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Ertasai, with honors. Simia Wong, with distinction. Jason Song Chen Yin, with a minor in business. And participating from home, Raymond Lee, with honors, and a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Shujun Ni. And now, film.
Hi again. It is my very great privilege and honor and happiness to introduce our Bachelor of Arts in Film candidates. Congratulations, you guys.
Manuel De Valle, with honors. Chloe Fields, with honors. Zachary Simon Goldman, with honors. Christina Velazquez. Yi Qian Yang, with a minor in business. And participating from home, Nicole DeGrasse Mitchell, with honors. Jinghao Fong, with honors. Leon Gualar Diaz, with distinction. Li Dane Hu. Leanne Villarmino, with honors. Quinn Wall. Our next program is fine art.
Hello, my name is Laura Cooper. I'm the chair of the fine art program, and it gives me great pleasure to be able to introduce and present these wonderful, incredible artists for the degree of Bachelor of Fine Art in Fine Art. We are all so proud of you.
Jay Allegretti, with distinction. Michael Bardales Yurostegui, with distinction. Eden Moon Emmanuel. Devin Hernandez Horn, with honors. Saraya Mahamadi Sabet. Joey Sirikia, with distinction. And now, graphic design.
Hello again. First, Errol, thank you so much for being here and those amazingly good words. You have been a prime mover in moving graphic design from a commercial art to a brand leader in the world. And now I am pleased to introduce the candidates for the Bachelor of Fine Arts in Graphic Design. This group is extraordinary. Each and every one of them unique in their own incredible way. And remember, as I've often told you guys, the world belongs to you as much as the next fella. Don't give it up.
Athena Aquino, with distinction, and a Design Matters minor in social innovation. Rolanda Castillo, with honors. Ashley Chu. Guan Zhen, with distinction. Brian Josue Gonzalez. Nicole Wanya Kim, with honors. Jamie Lee, with honors, and a Design Matters minor in social innovation. Sue Lee. Angela Lee, with distinction. Ju Park. Tiffany Rachel Shen with distinction and a minor in business. Hannah Shin with a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Grace Francis Susilo with honors. Christy Toyota with honors. March Valenzuela. Bravo. Christine Wei with distinction. Yin Yang with distinction. Chi Zhu with a minor in business. And participating from home, Austin Inho Zhang. Jianhyang Zhang Kim with distinction. Shannon Tsai with honors and a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Tallulah Villarreal with a minor in business. Up next is illustration.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Aaron Smith, and I'm the Associate Chair of the Illustration Department. And on behalf of Ann Field, our chair, I'm very proud, particularly proud this term, to present the candidates for the Bachelor of Fine Arts in Illustration.
Jamie Beck, with honors. Nathan Andrew de Leon Bernal. Sabel Bronson with honors and a minor in creative writing. Andrew J. Yong Cho. Dana Densmore with honors. Lauren Fukushima with honors. Vanessa Gutierrez with distinction. Jacqueline Junha. Karen Hahn with honors. Alexander Henderson, with distinction. Gwendolyn Horta, with honors. Rena Jang, with honors. Mindy Kim, with honors, and a minor in business. Sangha Lee, with honors. Yushin Lin. Matthew Daniel Mata, with honors. Audrey Murty, with distinction, a Design Matters minor in social innovation and a second minor in business. Vee Nguyen, with honors. Do Yoon, Treasure Park. Yair Sarmiento. Milo Sherman, with distinction. Jenny C2. Andrea Sujipta. Fionn Giatet, with honors. Yilin Wang, with distinction. Alice Yang, with distinction. Yijun Zuo, with a minor in business. And participating from home, Se Chul An, Fiona Chen, Margot Chen, Jungmin Cho, with a minor in business, Shelby Mangialare, with distinction. Brandon Gully, with distinction and a minor in business. Liu Fei Ha. Paul Herr. Nicholas Kim. Nathan Kwan, with honors. Jasmine Rose Lee, with honors. Jason Han Lee. Siying Lee, with honors. Martina Liang, with honors. Jeffrey Liu. Nicole Rensky, with distinction. Richard A. Rodriguez, with distinction. Robert Chung To, with honors. Xiaojiao Zhou. Now we have interaction design.
Hello again, I'm Maggie Hendry, also chair of undergraduate interaction design. While each of these students is uniquely talented and have incredible work behind them, it is as a whole that they are deeply impressive. I am so aware of how they attend and care about one another's work that, to kind of riff on Errol, I think as a group, they're gonna go very far. So with all of that pride and joy, we present to our candidates for the Bachelor of Science in Interaction Design.
Gabriella Chen. Charlene Joy Guba de la Cruz, with honors, and a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Toby Karpenko, with distinction, and a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Jiaming Mao, with distinction. Anthony Palaleo, with distinction, and a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Huang Chen Ji, with honors, and a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Siladitya Sharma, with honors, and a minor in business. And participating from home, Bamsak Oh, with honors. Up next is photography and imaging.
Hello, my name is Anne Cutting. I'm the interim co-chair of photography and imaging department. It is my true honor and pleasure to introduce you to the candidates for a BFA in photography and imaging. Congratulations.
Ashley Baroni Butts, with honors. Eric Chang. Woo! Connor Doherty with honors. Dane Dyer with distinction. Brianne Johnson with honors and a minor in business. Juliet Lambert with honors. Sarah Sherman. Jack Thomas. M. Wright with distinction. Chi Wu with honors. And participating from home, Yifan Long. Kenna Rayner with honors. And now, product design.
Good morning, my name's Chris Hacker. I'm the chair of product design. And I can tell you that this group of industrial designers are amazing problem solvers. And the problem that they solved was getting through this pandemic and coming out with the kind of work that they did. They are truly amazing group. I'm here to present the Bachelor of Science for Product Design.
Jordan Ahmad with distinction. Ming-Li Chang with honors. Jian Chen with a Design Matters minor in social innovation and a second minor in business. Tony Chang. Krista Guzman with honors. Esther Kim with honors. Faith King with a Design Matters minor in social innovation and a second minor in business. Carl Lai. Sophia Lambrecht. Min Lee. Qingyu Lei with honors. Andy Lee with a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Ivy Chin-Yi Lee with honors. Jason Lee. Yankee Lee, with distinction and a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Cynthia Chin with honors. Huali Chu with honors. Lulu Tang with honors. Ching Yan with distinction. Dewey Yu with honors. Echo Wenjie Zhang with honors and a minor in business. And participating from home, Yanhui Ban, Lu Yi He, Sarah Hua with a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Jihei Lee with honors. Peggy Lee with distinction and a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Jianye Sun with honors. Nancy Tsai with honors and a Design Matters minor in Social Innovation. Bonnie Zhang with honors. Xinju Zhang. Finally, we have transportation design.
Hi again, I'm Jay Sanders, Executive Director of the Undergraduate Transportation Design Program. I had the great pleasure of seeing our graduating students present their amazing work to a Zoom room full of automotive executives this week. And I have no doubt that despite the many challenges they've faced, they'll continue the fine tradition of our alumni in helping lead this industry. So on behalf of Stuart Reed, Chair of the Transportation Design, I would like to announce the candidates for Bachelor of Science in Transportation Design.
Kellen Gustine with honors. Jun Yap Huang. Jinso Kim with honors. Kang Ho Kim. Rung Lee. Devin Parham. Ferrai Piloto with honors. And participating from home, Yinsu Jessica Che, Pierre Kohendet with honors, Hao Hu, Philip Junho Yang, Rui Lun Ji, Ryan Toops, Ji Chen Wang. Ladies and gentlemen, as we approach the end of the graduation ceremony, we ask everyone to please remain seated until all graduates have completed the recessional. Once again, please welcome Dr. Lorne Buckman.
Thank you. Before I officially confer the degrees, I invite everyone to visit our virtual graduation show at artcenter.edu to see the work assembled by our graduating students. If you haven't seen it yet, I encourage you to do so. It's extraordinary, and the site will remain active as a testament to their incredible work and dedication. And now, on that note, it's time for me to officially confer your degrees. So would you all, graduates, please stand? All right, here we go, here we go. Hang tight for just a minute. And those of you and remotely, I'd like you to stand too. Ready? On the recommendation of the faculty, and on behalf of the trustees of Art Center College of Design, it is with great pleasure that I confer upon the fall class of 2021 the degrees issued here today with all the rights and privileges and honors pertaining thereto, and given under the seal of the college at Pasadena by the authority vested in the trustees by the state of California on December 18, 2021. Congratulations, graduates.
Thank you for joining us today. That concludes the graduation ceremony. Thank you.